Alright, before this video gets started today, there's just a few things I want to say, and that is that this is the hardest decision I've had to make in a very long time. Let me also say that my decision about whether or not I should buy the veteran LYNX depends a lot on my own personal circumstances and may not necessarily apply to you. That means that if I were to come to the conclusion that I can't or shouldn't buy the veteran LYNX right now, that does not necessarily apply to you. This means that after much painstaking thought analysis and deliberation about whether or not I should kick this big, beautiful Bertha to the curb, this veteran Sherman that I'm riding now and have been riding for over 2 years, I need to consider these important factors before I drop nearly $5,000 into the new state-of-the-art wheel, the veteran LYNX. It is with great displeasure and sadness that I have to declare that my time to buy a new wheel, namely the veteran LYNX, is not yet upon us. Let's watch this video, hear me out, and let me explain to you why. Hello, hello, and welcome back to another video. How are you doing today, folks? It's time to go on a ride uptown via 3rd Avenue in Manhattan to the South Bronx, which is just above 125th Street. Today I'm riding pretty cautiously. I am holding something in my hand, and the weather outside is about 27 degrees, so it's below freezing. It's extremely cold, but I'm bundled up nicely. I have my leather jacket on, I have my gloves. Of course, I'm geared up with my knee pad, helmet. Bluetooth device is turned on and connected in my helmet. So if I go too fast, which I probably won't, I don't think I'm gonna break the 48 mile per hour barrier on my wheel on this gentle cruise in the Manhattan city streets. That would be insane. I'm already going like 15-20 and it feels crazy with all these cars and people. Imagine me barreling up these streets at 50 miles an hour. I'm not gonna pass this truck on the right. That just seems risky and unnecessary, but I am gonna absolutely pass him on his left, where hopefully he can see me clearly and not accidentally get too close to me. Folks, welcome back to another video. I'm so excited to be out here on these streets. I love it. I love riding. I love recording. I love chatting it up while I'm recording. I rarely ride without recording now, so that should give you an idea as to how often I ride now, which is not that often. And I love the feedback. I love seeing the crazy numbers going through the ceiling lately. And I'm not talking about millions or anything like that, but it's going through the ceilings for me. Relative to my channel and to my success, this is huge progress. More people from out there are catching on to the magic that is happening right here at EUC NYC. Guy, welcome to the family, all you new subscribers. Over 100 new subscribers in a short time compared to a typical average of 30 new subscribers per month. Already 100 within the last few days. I don't even know what to say. I'm literally thrilled. We're about to hit 1,000 subscribers. And at the same token, we're this close to hitting the watch hour threshold for monetization, right around the same time as the subscriber count threshold. So somehow, some way, we went from gradually and casually doing this fun as a hobby to potentially, upon review, getting completely monetized and paid for these ride-in chats. My goodness, I mean, I don't even know what to say. It seems surreal. It doesn't seem real yet. It hasn't sunk in. I can't believe that I could potentially be riding and working at the same time by riding and by talking. You want to know why that's great? It's not because of somehow this. It's because it's fun doing this. It's fun. Imagine I told you, hey, what do you like to do for fun? And you said, play chess. And I was like, okay, here, play chess. And as you're playing, I'm just going to pay you for playing. You'd be like, what? What did you just say to me? Probably something like that. That's kind of how it feels. So listen, I'm not going to count my eggs before they hatch or anything like that. I'm not even going to be stoked and looking forward to it or anything like that. I'm just going to keep doing what I love and doing what I do, which is riding, doing my rides, turning on my camera, and speaking to you guys from the heart, unscripted, without any ill will or ill intention, and actually with good intention. Sometimes I'm trying to share knowledge, ideas with you, discuss important topics with you. It's all just a very fun and very hopefully mutually beneficial, thank you, and mutually beneficial activity that's going on here at EUC NYC, guy, and we're going to keep it that way. And even if it doesn't work out or it doesn't get monetized or anything of the sort, it's still absolutely a great thing that I love to do and will continue to do as long as I have the strength and the will to carry on. Folks, how are you doing? What's going on with you? Leave a comment below to make yourself known so I know who's out there. Sometimes I even click on your names and see if you've uploaded any videos, get to know you a little better. Or sometimes I'm thought provoked by your comments or ideas or suggestions. Sometimes your comments and suggestions out there actually help make this channel better. This is our channel, literally. I mean, it's a project that we're built together. So viewers out there, thank you so much. And even if you're just saying kind words in the comments, like cool dude and thank you, thank you. Thank you for making my day. I really do appreciate it. So many of you are just like, cool content, keep it up, brother. I can't tell you how much that means to me. It's a pretty basic, simple thing, but it really means a lot. It makes me very happy. And I just have an endless pool of gratitude for you guys. Thanks so much. All right, this is the Willis Avenue Bridge I'm on right now. I don't know what to say about this bridge, except that it can get kind of scary sometimes, especially during rush hour, when you have like 20 bikes in a row coming at you at 40 miles an hour, and you guys are just like inches away from each other. It can get kind of scary, especially when you're going 40 and they're going 40. That's 80. That's like when I'm like, oh, I wish I had body armor, or I hope nobody's on their phone and not focusing on the road and accidentally clips me or something. I like literally sometimes cross my arms on my chest to protect my vital organs when I'm on this thing. Because it's just a kind of a scary thing. But I'm always with a helmet now, thankfully, and knee pads. When I fell before going really fast, my knee pads took the brunt of the damage. So to me, knee pads have become just as vital as the helmet. The helmet is just a non-negotiable, because even though my head didn't get hurt, I was lucky for that. And you just don't want to take the risk of hurting your head, because that's your noodle. That's your moneymaker. That's your noodle scratcher. So, and gloves, honestly, and when it's cold like this, 29 degrees, you've got to have gloves. That's also a non-negotiable. Sorry, but like, I've done the no glove thing in the cold a couple times, and I was like, why am I doing this? This is horrible. So guys, gear up. If you're scooter riding, bicycle riding, doesn't matter what you're doing. If you're on a wheel, you might be able to get away with it, because you can kind of put your hands in your pocket or whatever, because you're on a wheel, you have hands free. So I guess that's cool. Well, I'm gonna steal this light. I'm gonna steal it. Yes, just saved like 20 seconds. What am I gonna do with my newfound glorious time that I just earned by making an unsafe decision? No, it wasn't unsafe. I looked, there was no cars coming. I have plenty of room and time. Stop criticizing me and judging me with your eyes. So did anyone out there buy a veteran LYNX or make a pre-order? If you did, say so in the comments. I'm trying to gauge how many people out there are really pulling the trigger. As for me, honestly, listen, I still have this veteran Sherman that I haven't squeezed all the value out of yet. So I feel kind of guilty pulling the trigger on a nearly $5,000 purchase when the value gained is going to be kind of a thin margin. I hate to say it, but it's realistically and practically speaking, I'm really only gaining a thin margin of improvement on lifestyle going from the veteran Sherman OG to the veteran LYNX. Now I know the LYNX has incredible technology. That scared me. That was scary. Okay, I was about to go right. Anyway, I know the LYNX has technology and it's lighter and new battery and it's so cool and looks great and it's all this great stuff about the LYNX, but I just am having trouble justifying it unless I can get a pretty penny for my veteran Sherman OG. And if you're wondering, I'm thinking 2,000 or 2,500 is a fair number, but I know that resale value, based on the numbers out there, is really leaning more towards 1,100 to 1,500. And that kind of makes me sad. It almost makes me want to just do a hand-me-down with my veteran Sherman if I'm really going to spend that money and get the LYNX, because it's like the veteran LYNX, at that price difference, it's like buying a whole new wheel and completely getting nothing for your old wheel. And your old wheel will basically get you around town just as fast and just as comfortably, almost, with a few exceptions, as the veteran LYNX. So I don't know. Who knows if my mind will change or if I end up getting the amount of money for my Sherman that I think is fair, allowing me to do the upgrade. I don't know if that's going to happen. But if it doesn't, I'm just going to go out and say it right now. I don't know if I'm going to make the upgrade. Guys, thanks so much for tuning in. Again, I can't thank you enough. I hope you enjoyed this. I look forward to seeing all of you on the next one. Have a great day. Goodbye.